Detroit es una ciudad en guerra. Y se ha prohibido totalmente el acceso a un área de 150 manzanas. Paracaidistas del ejército, soldados de la Guardia Nacional, policía local y estatal siguen enfrentándose a un puñado de francotiradores.
Diga. Todo en orden. Aquí está todo tranquilo. Dormiré cuando acaben los disturbios.
How did you get into the psychology of a racist, and how did you get out of it?
Really, it's about sort of, I think, acknowledging just how ignorant, you know, racists are inherently, and how their ideologies and their opinions are flawed because they're built on lies and ultimately propaganda. So, first, by understanding that, you can sort of, I think, even begin to kind of step into their shoes. And once you understand that, it's going to require you to embrace ignorance and be self-righteous in your ignorance, then you have a chance of playing them. If you're looking for truth, if you're looking for any kind of sound logic, you're not going to find it. And then I think you might miss the mark in that respect.
Es una zona de guerra. Están destruyendo la ciudad.
¡La ventana, bárbaro!
¡Hala! ¿Lo estáis viendo?
No estamos lejos del motel allí. Vámonos aquí hasta que se calmen las cosas.
Ser negro es como tener una pistola apuntándote a la cara.
I would be doing a disservice to Mark Bowl if I didn't mention just how phenomenal the script was. And of course, Catherine too, you know. Together with Barry Aykroyd, who's the DOP, she was able to create an unbelievably immersive, you know, experience, particularly when it came to shooting the Algiers Motel incident. You know, there was a intensity, you know, that sort of clung to the walls of that motel, and a tension in the air when we were shooting those scenes that you couldn't help but feed off, and it informed all of our performances, and I think, you know, made the film as captivating as it is.
Nos están disparando.
Han disparado cerca del motel Algiers.
Tíos, aquí fuera hay policías.
Most of the cast that feature most heavily are African American, but there are British members in me and Hannah Murray and John, and then there's an Australian in the shape of Ben O'Toole, and an Irishman in the shape of Jack Rayner. You know, I think for us, we feel like we're all engaging in a global story, you know, because race relations is an international topic, of course. And so there's a need for everyone to participate in the telling of these sorts of stories, and you know, we were all honored to participate.
Tengo toda la noche. Quiero saber exactamente lo que ha pasado. Necesito que sobrevivas.
I think it was you before that you mentioned something about when you met John for the first time. That was in a casting?
Yeah. We met each other in the hallways, you know, on the way to an audition. You know, I'd been a fan of John's work before we got the chance to work together, and you know, we'd expressed a mutual desire, I think, to just want to do something together, and it's just so befitting that this is it, you know, that we get to come together and make a film like this. And I really hope I get to work with John again, because I think he's a very, very talented actor.
But he did say you got the role that day.
I got the role that day, but trust me, John Boyega's getting all the roles these days, so and I'm glad to see it. He deserves it.
¿Creéis que es un farol? ¡Lo tenéis crudo!